school. Remember, there's no school like the old school, and I'm the headmaster. Anyway, just to sort of carry on from my last cast, and we were just sort of talking about the PlayStation, you know, the first edition of the PlayStation. I got, got it on launch day. Absolutely loved it. Really, really loved it. I just wanted to talk a little bit about the games and, you know, all the peripherals and things like this that were going on with PlayStation at the time. Like I said, I got many games. I was a big first adopter of the PlayStation. Enjoyed it immensely. But also really enjoyed the improved graphics, the improved sound, improved everything really. And for me personally, I really did see this as, gaming had suddenly come of age almost, so before it was quite kiddie-like almost, a lot of the games, but, suddenly now it come a teenager and it was a man or whatever analogy you want to go for. So the PlayStation for me, brilliant game. It did some pretty cool stuff. Like I say, there was a couple of games. I already talked a little bit about Resident Evil 1 and 2. Absolutely brilliant games, unbelievable games for me. The horror genre really started kicking in. And I loved every minute of that. And the second game for me that made me change, made me sort of think about gaming in a slightly different way than I had done before on the PlayStation was Metal Gear Solid. And again, this was like a strategic sort of war game. Again, it was sort of the cinematics of Metal Gear Solid were pretty, pretty incredible. Again, nothing like anything I'd seen before, gaming wise. It was like almost like a mini movie. And I remember I had sort of like almost flashbacks, which is ironic because there was a game called Flashback, which I used to play back in the day. And Flashback was one of these. It was just like a platform game. It was and you were like, a secret agent, sort of fighting aliens and all these things in this very alien environment. Very, very cool. I think it might be revamped or anything like this or anything like that. But anyway, graphics, beautiful graphics, incredible. But Metal Gear Solid was a game again where hours, days, weekends literally just disappeared for me. And like I say, I was involved, and it's really brought out the sort of gamer in me, and I just couldn't get enough. It's like when you get a good book, you can't put it down. You want to get to the next chapter. You want to get to the next page. You want to get to the next part of the story. And Metal Gear Solid for me was that game. Again, it was a slightly different way of playing, because you not only had a war element to it, but again it was this sort of maverick soldier that didn't do things by the book, did it his way, was this specialist. Pretty cool. Again, Metal Gear Solid for me took gaming to a whole new level. So that was the sort of PlayStation, the original PlayStation. And the console itself, I really liked the console. It was this sort of grey, very sort of cool grey colour. And the controller was, again, they just got it right. They got it perfect. With the first one, didn't have the thumb controls that we all use and love these days. But that didn't take long actually for that to come through. But they got it right. I mean, the controller which I use now for the PS4 is pretty much the same, apart from it's a rumble and it's wireless and all of these things. But it is pretty much the same, the same controller, which I think is pretty a testament to these guys back in the day when they were, like I say, future proofing this thing. So they got it absolutely bang on. So the PlayStation 1 was pretty cool. I know a lot of people had a lot of issues with things like the laser not reading properly. I think I did as well. And brilliant, called up Sony or got in contact with Sony, say, look, I've had this, God knows, I don't know how long I've had it. But the lasers stopped reading properly. Instant response, send it back to us, we'll get you a new one. So they'd obviously worked on customer service, knew exactly responses that needed to be had to keep their customers loyal. If they had a product which was a little bit glitchy, and they just said, oh well, that's it, guarantee over, I don't think they'd be where they are today, to be honest. So yeah, that I can't fault them in that sense, but I was a little bit annoyed in that. I suppose I tried all the normal tricks, turning the PS upside down, all of these things that I'd heard people trying. The other thing I want to sort of brush on with the PS, the original PS, is the Game Shark, which I managed to get hold of. Now, these days it's a very, very sort of different sort of thing that you'll use this for. But the Game Shark was essentially where you could unlock new characters in a game, or you could unlock cheats and things like this, and it would just stick in the back of the PlayStation, and it would go into it was almost like a printer port, that type of thing. So you'd shove it in the back of the PlayStation, whatever game you were playing, there'd be a code, and you would have all of the, all the cars unlocked, or all the characters unlocked, or just extra things that you wouldn't normally get. So it's pretty cool bit of device. And I sort of had that sort of late on, so I'd almost finished with my PlayStation, with my original PlayStation, when I got wind of this and started using it. Prior to that, obviously I was working hard over the weekends to unlock all my characters the purest way, by playing the game fully. And I was just sort of thinking about this the other day, about how each console, and I'm stuck now. We're at the PlayStation sort of mark in my gaming cycle, and I'm stuck with PlayStation now through thick and thin. So I'm up to PlayStation 4, and I'll talk about all the other versions prior to that, in other episodes. But I was thinking about this the other day, and I've had friends that have had PlayStations that have moved over to the Xbox, and vice versa, people that were on the Xbox that have come over. And it really is quite tribal. It really is sort of quite black and white for people. People do love or hate the opposite consoles that they're on. And if you have a friend that goes over to the Xbox, it's like losing a friend. Like, oh no, or it's like having a friend that stops supporting the team that you've supported as childhood, through your childhood or something like that. All of a sudden they've now taken on a different shirt. It's like, oh, it's a quiet betrayal. So I mean, they the marketing of these things, they've got it bang on. They've absolutely got it bang on. But anyway, I mean, I love gaming. I do love all that. The Xbox is a pretty cool machine. I'm not going to sit here, and I'll probably get slated for that, but from all the Sony PlayStation fans and gamers. But, you know, they've all got their pros and cons. And for me, still PlayStation, just, you know, at this moment in time, is still, you know, a little bit ahead of the game. They've got a lot of very, very cool things. But I, you know, there's a lot of things moving around in the market at the moment, and it'll be interesting to see where it does go. But anyway, let's get back to original PlayStation. So I know they did, you know, and one thing, this is what I quite like about Sony. Actually, I like it and I hate it as well, to be fair, is the fact that they don't just stick with a single model. They will, you know, if they can get this their console smaller, thinner, faster, they'll do it. So, you know, the PlayStation, the original PlayStation, had many sort of upgrades through its time before the PlayStation 2 came out, and I just stuck with the original, and which I've done through all of my PlayStation upgrades. The originals that, you know, like PlayStation 1, I just had the original PlayStation 1. I didn't upgrade. I had to get a new one because my laser, I started messing around. The disc wasn't reading, or it was random. But that was really just an error, a fault in the actual manufacturing, or overusage, whatever you want to call it. And so that was pretty cool. And I never really went for the PlayStation 1 and these sorts of things. Possibly because I already had a PlayStation, I didn't, you know, I didn't want to keep forking out for newer, thinner models. But I actually, if I hadn't got one, you know, at the time, and I was just coming into the PlayStation, I quite like the idea that I would have something slightly different, something newer, thinner than that come out, maybe, just to sort of differentiate it. So anyway, so I then obviously still loving the PlayStation, was waiting for the PlayStation 2 to come up. Now the PlayStation 2 was a very different looking machine. You know, it's this sort of square or sort of more boxy sort of looking, but with the fins in all the way around it. But actually it started looking quite stylish. Less like a kid's game console and more like an adult, part of your stereo system, shall we say, or if you had separates, it would, it started looking a little bit like that. They were definitely going for more of an adult, you know, aiming for the adult market, that's for sure. Still the same brilliant games, but the PlayStation 2 started looking pretty cool, that's for sure. The difference with both of the, you know, PlayStation 1, PlayStation 2, obviously graphically, you know, the power, it was a much bigger power, you know, a more powerful machine, I should say. And the PlayStation 2 just, again, I think they were now sort of thinking, right, we've got the market here, no one's still coming on board, no one's still challenging, we're going to sort of go for the jugular. And we'll sort of, you know, I'll leave it there at the moment, and we'll talk a little bit more about the PlayStation 2 and, you know, again, the peripheral that I had with the PlayStation 2 as well. So, you know, like the light gun, I mean, I started playing Time Crisis. Time Crisis was amazing. These sorts of things were absolutely brilliant. And you had a light gun with that, which was Namco's light gun, was brilliant. On the PlayStation 1, actually, we'll take it from there. So, anyway, tune in for more talk on Game School, and just leave you with one thought. There's no school like the old school, and I'm the headmaster.